ప్రపన్న పారిజాతాయ తోత్ర వేత్రైకపాణయే జ్ఞానముద్రాయ కృష్ణాయ గీతామృతదుహే నమః. ఓం నమో వెంకటేశాయ. మై బెస్ట్ విషెస్ అండ్ పరిపూర్ణ ఆశీర్వాదం టు ఆల్ ద వ్యూవర్స్ ఆఫ్ శ్రీ వెంకటేశ్వర భక్తి ఛానల్. మే ద ఆల్ మైటీ శ్రీ లార్డ్ వెంకటేశ్వర బెస్టో ఆల్ కైండ్స్ ఆఫ్ ప్రాస్పరిటీ, హెల్త్, వెల్త్, ఎటర్నల్ హ్యాపీనెస్ విత్ కంప్లీట్ లక్ష్మి కటాక్షంస్ టు యూ అండ్ యువర్ ఎంటైర్ ఫ్యామిలీ మెంబర్స్. లెట్ అస్ బిగిన్ భగవద్గీత వర్డ్స్ నంబర్ 3 ఆఫ్ 7th చాప్టర్. శ్రీ భగవానువాచ మనుష్యాణాం సగస్రేషు కశ్చిద్ యతతి సిద్ధయేన్ యతతామపి సిద్ధానాం కశ్చిన్ మాం వేతి తత్వతః. The reality of the knowledge of God is revealed by Bhagavan Krishna himself. In the 6th chapter, he told the glory of the self-effort, but that self-effort has got its own limitation. What kind of limitation? Because when you are not made proper effort, there is a chance to get failure in the research. Because we have to be aware and careful with the process which is known as Shravana Mananam, the study of the spiritual life. Now, why the people are not attracted with the destination called Moksham? Swamiji, I don't want to have Moksha right now. For me, my grandchild or children should get admitted in the proper school. That is what, you know, the proper need. Now for them, the big ultimate destination seems to be small, useless. And this small destination seems to be very big. They are meaningful. Moksha becomes meaningless. They are not attracted towards the proper destination, but they are attracted towards this temporary destination. It's because of what? Not only now, from the Puranic time, we have the same deficiency in our society. A society which should give the priority to the main destination. In India alone, the main destination called Moksha is worshipped, but at present it is not glorified. But in ancient time, every scripture talks about that great destination. Because you can find, you know, there is a difference between the destination among the people when they fix in their life. These all foreign people, they fix even climbing on the mountain, reaching the Everest is the destination. But Indian, we don't fix those things as the destination because it's not famous. In India, we need to get a house. We need to get the job security. We need to get a proper family. And especially we need to get a nuclear family, not joint family. But in foreign countries, ulta. They want to get a relationship, but we are born with so many relatives. Therefore, when they were born, so this father and mother separated. Now father is with the other mother and the mother is with another husband. So for them, getting relationship relatives is a big task. The destination differs according to the place. The society which should provide the clarity on the destination, but now at present there is no clarity on their destination. And so many ads, media influence, it confuses more. When you are not having the clarity on the destination, you cannot lead your life with the clarity. Now this destination, it seems to be valueless and useless. Therefore, we need to have a proper system, a proper person who can channelize your ideologies. Now, the science is, it has improved a lot. We have invented so many glories. Because of the science, we can atoms get connected with the throughout universe, and even you can have eye on all other planets, even on the planet Earth, around the planets, Moon, Mars, even, you know, sun rays also measured by the satellites. We have got innumerable glory, but in one part, when the science makes effort to find the cause of the universe, the creation, it gets the failure. Why? The science always, it does its research, that which is oriented by or which is dependent by experiment based. The science does its research based on experiments. But a spiritual seeker, when he does the research, but this research is known as inquiry. The inquiry of the universe. Because God is not visible. He is in invisible form. So God realization only will happen when you realize. Therefore, what? You cannot search God in the world. But God exists in the world, but in the invisible form. That invisible God to be realized how? Should I break the atom till I find the God like Hiranyakashipu? Now this spiritual seeking or inquiry is based on self-experiences. Now you need to have a guru who can make you to realize or understand the difference between inquiry and research. The research is towards outside, and inquiry is based on self-experience. Therefore, we begin from tvam padartha visheshaha. The experience must be began from ourself. Once you are given a proper channel to lead your life with the self-inquiry and God inquiry, definitely you will get complete realization of the God. Now the science is also digging to find what is the cause of the entire universe or creation. The spiritual seeker also makes effort to realize the same thing but in different way, without any experiments, without any equipments, without any expenditure, but he reaches the goal, he gains the benefit, that is the fantastic. So first you realize about the God, that God and the destination is one and the same, he will get that limitlessness. That is the glory. Therefore, Krishna here, he continues. First, he gives the rarity of this destination, of this realization. Then he continues. So, till these verses, from verse number 1, 2, 3, till this verse, from the beginning, so introduction of the 7th chapter has been completed. Now, from next verse, Krishna begins a proper knowledge of the 7th chapter, which is known as Ishvara Swarupam. Ishvara Swarupam will be discussed or inquired or revealed from verse number 4 to 12. Let us read it. Bhumi rapo nalo vayuho khammano buddhirevacha ahankara iti yamme bhinna prakriti rashtadha. So now, this shloka begins to reveal the secret of Ishvara. But before entering into the words, you have to have one clarity. That clarity is, Krishna is not teaching about Ishvara from his own idea. No. This is not only the Krishna's philosophy. People interpret in many ways. This is not Krishna's philosophy. This philosophy is from Upanishads. This teaching is from Upanishads. This Upanishadic teaching alone revived by Lord Krishna for Arjuna. Okay? Now Upanishadic teaching is revealed. So now Krishna brings the same method when you approach the God which is to be followed in the form of Upanishadic teaching. Based on Upanishadic teaching, now we are going to learn. This is the main portion of the seventh chapter. Even this is the main subject matter and main portion, important portion of whole Bhagavad Gita, where the nature, ultimate nature of the God is being unfolded. Now we have to be introduced little bit how the God is approached, because God is not visible. So only the world is visible. Now we automatically we have a kind of understanding. The world is not made up of a human being, because this is beyond human power. There must be some power by which or through which the world is being created. Now the world exists. World is an evident for me. There must be somebody. Now, for example, if I bring any product, a simple pot, if I take the simple pot, if I ask you, the pot exists, isn't it? You will also say, yes, sir, pot exists. If I say the pot exists, there must be a person who made the pot also should exist. You cannot deny it. Yes, of course, there must be the pot maker. Because of him, the pot exists. Now, whether pot maker is alive or not, so that pot maker's existence is confirmed by the pot existent alone. Okay, it's very simple. By seeing the pot, you will understand there must be somebody who made the pot. In the same way, world exists. Where is the author of the world? Or what kind of power which has created world, that which is experienced by us? Okay, that is the way when you make the inquiry. Now when you go to the temple, you know, a devotee, when he goes to the temple, he goes to the temple and he sees the God and he has his own prayer. He asks so many things. The God seems to be as a stone or panchaloka dhatu. That five metals, five kinds of metals, which is known as gold and silver, iron, or some kind of tuttanag, so many things. There are five kinds of metals are used to create a deity of the God. He goes and he stands in front of the deity, whether it is made up of stone or some kind of metals. Just he asks that too, you know, big things. I need to have a bungalow, car. So many things. That deity doesn't want anything. But he believes that God has the capacity. Because he is informed, God is everything, that power can produce or could supply the things which I ask. Now the difference between the seeker and devotee only believes and asks, but a seeker who is also a devotee, he also does the research, how that miracles happens. When you ask, he provides. That is the wonder. It means what? So he must be the creator of the world. That is the Upanishadic approach. And Swamiji, it's very simple. God is the maker. No. All mind cannot accept it. These atheist people, they say that there is no God. There is no God, there is no form for the God. That's what their conclusion is. But if you are a non-atheist, so you have a kind of belief God is a maker, a creator of the world. So when you could accept this fact, so your life is settled. Whether you are a seeker to realize the God doesn't matter. Without even realization of the God, if you have the complete faith, He is the creator. So He can create the world for me. The world which I like. That belief itself enough to Him or for Him to lead His whole life. But mind, you know, sometimes it believes, sometimes it cannot. Therefore, we have to have a proper research, which is in the form of inquiry. What is God? Now, God, Upanishad defines, any material should have the cause. Okay? If I bring the pot, pot should have two kinds of causes. So first cause is the materialist cause. That material cause is known as clay in the pot. So mere clay is the materialistic cause. This material cause, which is also known as raw material. So only by having material you cannot get the product. There must be one more cause. That cause, when you have clay, there must be the pot maker. Not only the pot maker, he should have the wheel, he should have the stick, he should have poured water, and he should have kept in the fire. So all these things are known as intelligent cause. Now any product is required two kinds of causes. Materialistic cause and intelligent cause. Known as Upadana Karanam, Nimitta Karanam. So that is what Upanishadic stand. So the world exists. The world has got two kinds of causes. Now God, is He materialistic cause or intelligent cause? Then immediately the answer comes, God is both. And Upanishad also doesn't live as in the sky or in the space. It gives a solid example. Upanishad, it won't open its mouth without an example. The best example is a spider and a web. Because when you want to construct the house, you need to have so many materials. All material won't become house their own. You need to have engineer, architect, mason, and so many other things also. Equipments, machineries, all these things will help the material to become the house. Even human intelligence also should be involved in it. So like that, this world, wonderful world. Now you see your body. No mother is aware how to create liver, lungs, kidney, gallbladder, large intestine, small intestine, even brain, you know, that is a great. She does only her own survival. But the things are getting created, that's what you know. So she may be, seems to be a cause, but beyond her there must be some cause through which this body is created. That's what we call it, Ishvara's Anugraha. So Ishvara is the materialistic and the intelligent cause. Give an example, the web is created by this spider. The web, the material, you know, it comes from the spider alone. It's a wonder. And it's very stronger than other material. Even now I heard they are trying to create a bulletproof kind of some kind of armor through this spider. You know, The Westerners, they have a hero called Spider-Man. But our Upanishad also uses the same example in order to realize the concept of the God. Now the world has got two kinds of causes. One is Upadana Karanam, another is Nimitta Karanam. Upadana Karanam means raw material, which is in the form of cause. And the second one is intelligent cause, which is known as Nimitta Karanam. Now, the world caused by two kinds of causes, and what can be the materialistic cause? What is the Nimitta Karanam, intelligent cause? Both of them are God. How? That is what is explained by Krishna in different way. Bhumi rapo nalo vayuhu khammano buddhireva cha ahankara yati yamme bhinna prakriti rashtadha. For us, world is made up of five elements. Okay? What are the five elements? Earth, water, fire, air and space. Now, the science also deals with the same five elements, but Krishna gives three more. Manaha, Buddhi, Ahankaram. This is known as Prakriti, the new technical term. The Jagat, you know, what we call it the world, it is said by Lord Krishna, Jagat. Jagat means what? Jayati, Gachati, Iti Jagat. That which is manifested and that which is destroyed. That which is born, that which is gone. Born and gone. The meaning of Jagat is born and gone. Okay? That itself a wonder. The Sanskrit, you know, when it gives the technical term, it has got its own vyutpatti, the method to define the meaning of the word. It's beautiful. Now this Jagat has got eight kinds of amshas. But for us in the science, they divide only the five elements. Among the five elements also, the space is defined by science in different way. The space is defined by our spiritual text, our scripture in different way. Space is the cause of other elements. Okay? Now, Bhagavan Krishna names one by one. Bhumi, he means earth. Apaha means water. Analaha means fire. Vayuhu means air. Kham means space. Manaha, mind. Okay? God, Jagat, does it have mind? You may ask. But Krishna brings very carefully, yes. Every material has got the mind. Even a desk and table, all the doors and walls, they are looking like the dead materials, but they do have also mind and buddhi. Not only that, they have their own intelligence. They are intelligent. Every piece of the sand is also having intelligence. Ahankara, they do have their own ahankara. Iti iyam me bhinna prakriti. Iti iyam bhinna prakriti ashtadha. Thus, the world, the prakriti, is separated in eight ways. Bhagavan Krishna continues, before that, the eightfold aspect is called Jagat. He is not spoken about Nimitta Karana or Upadana Karana, but without giving the technical term, he introduces the raw material of the world. This raw material of the world and the intelligent cause also introduced in different way. Now you see the five elements, it seems to be like raw material. And manaha, buddhi, ahankara, it seems to be intelligent cause. So when a river flows, river has got the five elemental source as the water. In the water there are four other elements also involved. That we will see later. But the flow, where the river gets its flow. Is there any big motor is pumping from the earth? No. Go to Gomukh. It's a beautiful place. Gomukh, where the Ganges, Ganga is originating herself. You go there. You go, your mind is being cleansed. Marvelous places. At least you have to go once in your lifetime. Gomukh. And there are so many other places, you know, you have to visit once in a lifetime. Even we call it Badri, Kedar, all these Char Dhams there. Even Kailas, Manasarovar. So this kind of destination we have to visit at least once in our lifetime. So when you go to Gomukh, you can see the water is flowing from the mountain. Underneath, you know. So it comes with a force. So who is pumping it? That's what, you know, the mind and intelligent force. It has also got prana, energy, that intelligence. It rejuvenates. Ganga cannot be polluted. But, you know, the invention of the human being can pollute anything. But Ganga is pure. You take a cup of Ganga jello, so you can keep it forever. It won't go decay. It won't get decomposed. It won't become polluted forever. It will remain with the purity. The quality cannot be reduced by any other source. Now Bhagavan himself, he has introduced, so he just given the Prakriti is 8 kinds. Prakriti means here we have to take as the creation, Jagat. Now the perception, only science gives there are only 5 elemental world, but Krishna gives, no, there are 8 kinds of amshas are there. We will continue from this verse from next episode tomorrow. Harihi Om. Om Purnamadah Purnamidam Purnat Purnamudachyate Purnasya Purnamadaya Purnamevavashishyate. Om Shanti Shanti Shantihi. Harihi Om. Shri Gurubhyo Namaha. Harihi Om.